Yo, what it do? It's your boy J. Lou, and you are just in time for something new. All right, now in today's video, what I'm going to be discussing is the Scotch Porter hair collection. Everything that you need to know in regards to these three products right here. So with that being said, let's not waste any more time and let's get straight into the video. All right, so if you are new to my channel, one thing that you guys need to understand is Scotch Porter reached out to me at the beginning of the year, sometime around April, to become an ambassador, you know what I'm saying? They wanted me to exclusively review their hair collection products. I've had it since April and I've been using the shampoo and the conditioner all throughout my videos. And I've also been using the hair balm. Now, when I first got the hair balm, I basically used that bad boy with the wash and the conditioner for a month straight just to see what I liked about it. And I also will post up some pictures of my results whenever I was using it during that time period, you know what I'm saying? Now, some of the things that you guys need to understand is, off top, when it comes to men's grooming, Scotch Porter is a household name. If you guys don't know, they've been mentioned in GQ, they've been mentioned in Forbes, they've been mentioned in Esquire magazine and things of that nature, you know what I'm saying? So their name is solidified. But a little thing that some of you guys may not know is that Scotch Porter is also a black-owned business, and all of their products are manufactured in the United States, New Jersey to be exact. So with that being said, whenever it comes to hair, especially if you have 360 waves, if you have natural hair, if you have dreadlocks or locks, or what most of the time people refer to, even if you try to rock braids or afro, whatever the case is, the number one important thing is that you have to keep your hair clean. So one thing that I like about the Scotch Porter hair collection is the fact that they decided to keep this mug very simple and straight to the point. You know what I'm saying? It only comes with three products: the shampoo, which they title the hair wash right here. Then they come with the hair conditioner. Now, the biggest difference between both of these products is the fact that this one is the cleansing agent, and then this one is the restorative agent right here. I believe on the front of it, it says that this is the hair wash with SP Hair Renewal Complex. It leaves the hair soft, shiny, manageable. It's 8 ounces, and the conditioner is the Scotch Porter's Hair Restorative Complex. They say that it leaves your hair soft, shiny, manageable, and it's 8 ounces as well. One thing that I can say, they definitely live up to the branding on the beginning, because it definitely leaves your hair soft, shiny, and manageable. Now, when it comes to the fragrance, a lot of people typically are concerned about that, because as a man, you don't want to be walking around smelling too fruity or too, like, whatever the case is. But you also don't want to be walking around smelling like boo-boo the food, you know? So, with that being said, when it comes to the smell on these products, the smell is very similar, and I believe it's because the main ingredients that they use, the top ingredients that they use, if you guys don't know, when you look at the ingredient label, from the left to the right, going down in that order, that's what comes first in the ingredients. And when you look at the back of this, the first thing it has is marshmallow root, slippery elm bark, nettle leaf, burdock root, neem leaf, horsetail leaf, as well as rosemary leaf and chamomile flowers. Now, for me, it kind of smells, I'm not going to say, I seen another YouTuber mention that it smells like root beer. I'm not going to say it smells like root beer. It smells like when you go into them old lady houses that have a lot of essential oils and herbs and things like that, and they pick up a bottle and you take a whiff of it. It has a very light but satisfying smell to it. You know what I'm saying? It smells more like an herb. And that may be due to the fact that it uses all of those roots, bark, and leaves and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? So when it comes to the smell matches in all three of them. So you're not going to have varying smells when you combine them together, and they're going to smell completely different. They're all going to smell the same. You know what I'm saying? Now, when it comes to the hair balm comes in a 3-ounce container. Now, one thing I want to mention about this is that the hair balm, they say that it leaves your hair soft, smooth, and shiny. This is the first time I've ever used a product that's 3 ounces. When you open it up, the thing I like about this one is it's a small container, and as you guys can see, the consistency is very light. It looks like a cream, but that's a similarity when it comes to balms. So balms and creams, I'm gonna get into a little bit more details about the balm a little bit later, but I like the fact that it is a balm. Now, when it comes to using these products, one thing that you need to understand is the ingredients that differ between the wash and the conditioner. This, when you go through the back of the ingredients, you will notice that a lot of the ingredients are very similar for the wash as they are in regards to the conditioner. But the biggest thing is this one has a lot more ingredients. Now, I do not believe Scotch Porter advertises themselves as being natural, organic, and everything like that. I know a lot of their ingredients on the back are natural ingredients, But at the same time, to be able to manufacture on the scale that they do, I believe some of these ingredients are not all the way natural, you know. So with that being said, that's not something to trip off of, because I'm going to do a video in the future in regards to the truth about natural versus unnatural products and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people, especially within the hair industry, they think that all natural is the only way to go, and that you shouldn't use any products that have anything that you can't pronounce. But at the end of the day, I make sure I link a video right above here where I went into detail just to kind of show you guys when it comes to the way you build a cocoa and shea pomade. Even though some of those ingredients you can't pronounce, a lot of those ingredients are natural ingredients. I didn't want to spend all of the time going back and researching every single one, because the thing about Scotch Porter is that they use a lot of ingredients, and because they've been around for a while, it's high quality ingredients as well. So with that being said, when it comes to the shampoo is going to have a lot more cleaning agents in it, because the shampoo is supposed to strip your hair to help clean it, and then the conditioner is supposed to go back in there and put a lot more of the oils or minerals and things that your hair needs in order to restore back. That's why they say that this is the restorative complex, you know what I'm saying? So now, another thing that I love about Scotch Porter is it comes with an instruction manual. If you don't have that in your order, what they do at the bottom of every single bottle is they put these tips and tutorials at the bottom, you know what I'm saying? Now, you don't have to go there, because I make videos to cover all of this stuff, but I just wanted to highlight that feature, because at the end of the day, that's very important when it comes to branding, you know what I'm saying? Now, when it comes to the shampoo and the conditioner, one thing that I noticed when it came to my hair, it made my hair extremely soft. And when it came to the shampoo, what I would do is just only use the shampoo, and then sometimes I would use the shampoo and the conditioner to see the effects. When I only use the shampoo, my hair has that clean, tingly sensation on my scalp for about a day and a half or so, whatever the case is. But if I use the shampoo and the conditioner the way that you're supposed to, my hair feels that way for at least 2.5 days. Now, I am low porosity, but at the end of the day, when it comes to washing your hair, porosity doesn't play a factor when you wash your hair, because everybody has to wash your hair. Porosity plays a factor when it comes to styling your hair. And the thing that I love about the hair collection is the fact that Scotch Porter has gone out their way to simplify the process when it comes to taking care of your hair. All you have to do is shampoo it, condition it, and then apply the hair balm in the direction or desired style that you want. Now, for me, I rock waves and things of that nature, you know what I'm saying? But I know there's a lot of people that tend to rock curls or whatever. One of the things that I did in the 30 days of only using these three products was that every now and then I would rock my hair in a curl state, you know what I'm saying? So, but when it comes to the process, all you do is shampoo, condition your hair, and then you use the hair balm. It follows the ideology of the LOC method to simplify the process, because a lot of people, especially men, are not aware of this stuff. But at the end of the day, the L stands for the conditioner when it comes to the LOC process. Now, some people may be saying,
well, how can they follow the LOC and you don't have an oil?
One of the things that a lot of people don't understand when it comes to conditioners, one thing that you will notice is the biggest difference in regards to the ingredients is with the conditioner, it has a lot more oils within it. So you're going to get that LO effect when it comes to the conditioner. Whenever you're washing your hair, you can choose to wash it with warm hair to wash all of the conditioner out. Or if you wanted to, you can rinse it out with cold water, you know what I'm saying? I don't believe that they advertise this as a leave-in conditioner, but I haven't had any issues leaving just a little bit of it in my hair, you know what I'm saying? But with that being said, I'm not telling you guys to use it as a leave-in conditioner. I'm just saying that whenever I rinse my hair with cold water, it doesn't get all the conditioner out, but I did not run into any issues just kind of going on about my way and everything like that, you know what I'm saying? So that covers the L and the O. The C comes in with the hair balm. Now, even though this is a hair balm, when it comes to the LOC, the C stands for a cream or a butter, you know what I'm saying? A balm fits into that same category, because a balm operates the same way as a cream, you know what I'm saying? Like when you open it up, I'll show you guys real quick. The consistency in regards to the product looks like a cream, you know what I'm saying? If you take it with your fingers, it moves, it basically rubs into your fingers very easily. Now, when it comes to balms typically have a greasier feel to them, depending especially on the ingredients. But one thing I want to highlight is the fact that when I use the Scotch Porter hair balm, it did not leave my hair feeling greasy. It felt more so waxy. You know what I'm saying? And for me, I don't have an issue with my hair feeling that way. Some people don't like the way that their hair feels when it feels greasy and stuff like that. But another thing that about the balm is that you do not need to use a lot of it. And at the end of the day, this can be used every single day if need be. So for me, somebody that's low porosity, after using a shampoo and a conditioner following the L and the O, by using a balm, I was able to use this product and go at least 2 to 3 days without having to put anything else into my hair. You know what I'm saying? Especially if I did not sweat or do anything crazy like that. I didn't run into any issues where I had to put more product in my hair. But if you are high porosity, what you may notice is that you probably have to put it in every single day. But the good thing is this product is light enough to where you can use it every single day. Now, when it comes to using the hair wash and the hair conditioner, I love the fact that they put it in these bottles, basically with these popper tops. I also have the beard collection. And one thing about the beard collection, when it comes to the conditioner, it comes in a container where you have to unscrew it. And if you are like myself, I typically wash my beard in the shower. Having that set up is not the go-to, but the fact that both of these things come with the pop tops, it allows you to be basically put it into your hand or whatever the case is, especially as a waver, as somebody as myself. Whenever I'm doing like wash and style or brush to dry and I decide to do it within the sink, basically wash my hair in the sink area, is great for that because I can basically put it over my head and just apply the product directly like that. All right, so after all of that has been said and done, I'll show you guys my results and everything like that. A lot of people will be wondering,
how much does this stuff cost?
When you buy all three of them together as the hair collection, it's gonna cost you $44.99 plus shipping and tax included. But one thing about the website is if you place an order anywhere of $50 and above, they give you free shipping as well. One thing I want you guys to consider is the fact that both of these things come in 8 ounces. And if you divide that total cost by three, you're looking to spend $15 on each one. You know what I'm saying? You basically get them in an all-in-one inclusive deal. Now, one thing as an ambassador is that every now and then they do have sales. And what I try to do is basically give you all the coupon codes and things of that nature on my social media accounts, whether if it's Instagram, if it's Facebook or even YouTube, you know what I'm saying? So if you guys are considering buying these things, but the price point is something that's kind of weighing you away, always be on the lookout because I always try to drop the codes whenever they give it. They typically give it around like holidays such as Father's Day and things of that nature, you know what I'm saying? But with that being said, the only drawback is that this is 3 ounces. But the thing is, you can use this bad boy almost every single day if need be. And it's a pretty light product. It's not the lightest. It'll give your hair minimal hold. It's not really made to hold your hair. It's like if you was to put it into another description, it would be more so like a double butter cream, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, there's certain things that differentiate a double butter versus a hair balm, you know what I'm saying? So this will give you some slight hold, but I would not recommend using this as a go-to for a product with hold, especially in the summertime. One thing that I noticed was during the summertime in Houston, man, as soon as I went outside, if I sweated or did anything of that nature, the products are sweating out my hair start frizzing up and things of that nature. So with that being said, that's another drawback. But one thing I want to point out about that is that happens with almost every single product that's on the market. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, some people can say that's a bad thing. Some people can
say, oh, I can deal with that. I manage that. I make sure I stay ragged up and everything of that nature. You know what I'm saying?
The last thing I want to say is another thing that separates Scotch Porter from other hair companies is if you buy these products and you say, okay, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and buy the product. At the end of the day, they give you a 60-day money-back guarantee. I haven't seen any hair company offer a 60-day money-back guarantee. And for me, that kind of shows that they are so confident in their product that you're going to love it. Otherwise, if you don't, they're going to give you your money back. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, always go into the website and see what the details of that is if you are concerned about that. But when it comes to about $15 per product, if you buy them together, that's not a bad deal at all, especially considering how much you're getting for it, you know what I'm saying? And the last thing I want to say is they give creators like myself the opportunity to become an ambassador. So anytime you guys choose to support Scotch Porter by using the link in my description, I'll make sure I put it in my description as well as the comments. If you buy any of their products through their link, I will be able to receive a small commission. And that's their way of giving back to the community that supports them and makes their brand what it is. So with that being said, I wanted to keep this video as honest as possible. Another thing that I love about Scotch Porter is Typically, before I post these videos, I send it to them just to get their approval, and they allow me to say whatever I want to say. So there's not a lot of companies out there that can take criticism or feedback, and the fact that they are open to doing that kind of stuff, that's what separates them even more. You know what I'm saying? Like I always say, when it comes to building a business, being able to receive feedback, especially constructive feedback, can only make your company better. The last thing I would say is that if they made this 4 ounces, they will probably set it off, man. Like I know a lot of people are typically used to 4 ounces within a wave game when it comes to butters and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully I answered everything that you needed to know when it comes to the Scotch Porter hair collection. If you like this video, make sure you drop a like, man. Make sure you do that. At the same time, if you feel like this was very informative, feel free to share it or add it to a playlist so you can watch it later, because there's a lot of gems that I dropped throughout my video and sometimes people miss them. So sometimes you got to go back and watch them again. So with that being said, it's your boy J. Lou. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your week. Salute. When I hop up out the bed, I stay brushing my waves. Even on my way to work, I stay brushing my waves. Oh, it's time for a break, I stay brushing my waves. Even when it get late, I stay brushing my waves. I stay brushing my waves. I stay brushing my waves. I stay brushing and brushing.